Thank you so much, BDM. I'm joined by Luis Scott Vargas, and we're here to talk Shota Yasooka's Grixis Control deck. So, Luis, Shota's known as kind of a control master. Why would you bring Grixis to this tournament instead of something like blue-black control, which is kind of a known quantity?
So the biggest price you pay in going to a third color is that your mana base gets a little bit worse, and you miss out on playing the three copies of Field of Ruin that a lot of the blue-black decks are playing. But you get some great finishers. Nicole Bolas, God Pharaoh, is one of them.
Absolutely.
Alongside the Scarab God and Torrential Gearhulk, and you'll notice that Shota played a little light on finishers, only actually four copies total, whereas some of these decks are playing like three Gearhulk, three Scarab God.
All right, let's take a look at Shota's counterspell suite that he has in his deck as well. Here we've got three copies of Disallow, two Essence Scatter, and two copies of Supreme Will.
So Disallow is the most powerful of these. Counters everything, no questions asked, and even stops things like Planeswalker Ultimates or other triggered abilities. Essence Scatter is cheap, it's efficient, slightly narrower range, and then Supreme Will is the most flexible of the three, just because if you don't need it as a counterspell, you can also use it to dig for one of your answers or even hit land drops.
Well, if you need counter spells, you probably also want removal. Let's take a look at some of the spot removal that Shota is running. We have a Fatal Push, a Braid, Harness Lightning, and a single copy of Unlicensed Disintegration.
So here's where the extra color really comes in handy. Shota's able to play a Braid, Harness Lightnings, and Disintegration, which the blue-black deck doesn't have access to, and these are very, very powerful cards. Harness Lightning gets pretty close to unconditional once you cast some Glimmers. Unlicensed Disintegration is unconditional, and then a Braid is flexible because it can also kill the artifacts.
Well, we are not done with the removal suite yet. We have more removal yet from Shota Yasooka. These cards kind of more overall removal. We have cards like Hour of Devastation. We have cards like Bantu's Last Reckoning and Vraska's Contempt in the deck as well.
So Shota has one copy of Bantu's Last Reckoning, one copy of Hour of Devastation, and those give his deck access to sweepers, which a lot of these decks don't have. And it makes it so it's a little harder to play against his deck, because against a blue-black deck like, say, Jerry Thompson was playing, you can play your fourth creature. You know that Jerry's going to have to deal with them one by one. Shota's got two sweepers, Bantu's Last Reckoning, Hour of Devastation. Vraska's Contempt as well is one of the more flexible answers. Exiles gets around the Scarab God's Return ability, can also kill Planeswalkers.
How relevant is the two life on this card as well?
It adds up, especially against Ramunap Red.
All right, let's take a look at his draw spells in the control deck here. Glimmer of Genius, which we've seen a lot of opt. He's the only player running this. And of course, the hallmark card, Search for Azkanta.
So Glimmer's pretty standard, especially when you have the energy package of Harness Lightning. It's a nice little bolster to that. Opt is a really interesting choice that kind of conflicts with one of the cards the other deck's playing, which is Censor. So they both cost one mana, get you an additional card. Opt is a little more powerful when you pay one mana, but of course, this doesn't have the Censor ability. So Shota's given up a bit of interaction in the form of Censor for slightly more powerful card filtering in Opt. Then, of course, Search for Azkanta. This is kind of what's driving the entire deck. It's true of the blue-black deck. It's true of the Grixis deck. You play this card early. It flips fairly quickly, especially with cards like Opt, Glimmer of Genius, 1-for-1 removal. Turns into Azkanta, the Sunken Ruin, at which point it adds another mana source, helps you play your 6 and 7 mana cards, and it's an engine. You pay 4 mana, you go ahead and look at your top 4 cards, and you pick up an extra card.
Yeah, BDM was telling me, you don't just give somebody like Shota a tool like Search for Azkanta and not expect him to just go crazy with it. All right, let's take a look at the non-basic lands that Shota is running here. And there you see Field of Ruin packing a single one of those, as well as Spire Bluff Canal, Fetid Pools, Drowned Catacomb, and Dragon Skull Summit.
Because Shota has to play a lot of these three-color lands, like Dragon Skull Summit, like Spire Bluff Canal, and then, of course, the regular blue-black duels, he does only have room for one Field of Ruin. And I know when he played against Josh Utter Layton yesterday in the blue-black versus Grixis Mirror, Josh having access to more copies of Field of Ruin meant that he won the battle over Azkanta the Sunken Ruin and eventually pulled ahead. So these are Shota's non-basics and only one copy of Field of Ruin.
All right, we have one more slide of lands to take a look at here. And I just want to ask you a question. How stretched is this mana base?
It's a little tight because you're trying to play double blue spells, double black spells, single red spells, and you're trying to do so early. There's even a double red spell in Hour of Devastation. So Shota does lose more games to mana base problems, but he has a more flexible and powerful suite of cards as a result.
All right, let's take a look at Shota's sideboard, see what he's packing to deal with the other decks he expected in the format. There's Vizier of Many Faces, Negate, Gonti, Lord of Luxury, as well as Duress.
So Negate and Duress are very effective tools in the control mirrors. They give you cheap interaction. They let you swap out your removal for something a little more relevant. Gonti is a pretty good catch-all. You can just put this card in any slowish matchup and you'll get a lot of good value out of it. Vizier is the card that has kind of kept Carnage Tyrant out of the limelight and is still quite good against the Scarab God, against Torrential Gearhulk, and against Bristling Hydra.
All right, let's take a look at the rest of Shota's sideboard. Chandra's Defeat, Essence Extraction, Fiery Cannonade, and Magma Spray. What's this cannonade doing in here?
So Shota's looking at all these cheap spells to kill cards out of Ramunap Red. Fiery Cannonade's a nice little sweeper, can take an Onkop Crasher, a Beaumont Courier, Soul Scar Mage, everything like that, alongside Magma Spray. And then you have Essence Extraction, which really helps you catch up because you're going to gain 3 life back that they may have taken from you.
Well, Luis, there's Shota Yasooka's deck. What do you think?
This deck looks pretty sweet. It gives you, again, access to some very powerful cards. And, of course, Nicole Bolas God Pharaoh.
Who can say no to Nicole? I certainly can't. All right. Thank you so much, Luis Scott Vargas. We'll be back after these messages.